Hey guys, welcome to Surf and Show. Today's vlog's on fins and answering some of the questions that I've been getting on Instagram and YouTube. The number one thing is for me on fins is if I'm 5'9 and 160 pounds, why am I riding a large fin instead of a medium? First of all, it's all about speed for me. Especially in smaller waves, I'm choosing a large fin with a wide base for maximum drive. In small waves, I have to generate my own speed and I need all the help I can get. So that's the number one reason why I choose a large fin. Now, another good question I get is, what are the downsides if you transition from a medium fin into a large fin, especially if you're a guy like me at about 160 pounds? Well, right off the bat, the board's gonna feel a little bit tighter. Now, I wanna choose my language specific. I always talk about stiffness. And stiffness equates to the flex in the fin, right? The opposite of loose on a board for me is tight. So because this fin doesn't go as deep into the water as a large fin does, it's gonna take a little bit more to turn it. So that's gonna tighten the board up a bit. But there's ways around that. One of the ways around keeping that large set of fins loose feeling is get a fin with less rake. Right? We talk about the rake or sweep in a fin will draw out your turns, it'll help you carve more, but it also tightens up the board. And I'll tell you why. Every shaper shapes a board and they have what that's called the shaper's dot. And that's where the back edge of the fin on the board is marked for where the fin boxes are set. And if we look at this fin right here, this right here is the trailing edge of the shaper's dot. So if you drew an imaginary line from here to about right here, everything that goes this way back behind the shaper's dot creates that rake, which is gonna draw out the turn, and it's also gonna stabilize the board and make the board a little bit tighter. Now, what is it that we're looking for and when would we want a board to be tighter? Well, when we're surfing bigger waves and we want to carve more, more sweep gives us more control, helps us pick our sections and hit our turns, right? So on smaller waves, we probably don't want a fin with a ton of sweep in it. Kind of like the AM2 right here, a lot of sweep. But what Channel Islands did that I like a lot is they made a shorter or smaller center fin. And that's what's going to keep the fin and the board feeling a lot looser and a lot more playful. It's really easy to think about it. If you had a twin fin with a small trailer, think of how large the twin fin side fins are. That's your drive, right? And the little tiny center fin is so much smaller that it gives you traction, but it keeps the board loose and playful. The next question I get is mostly about people that ride futures or FCS. They're trying to find the right fin for what they're looking for if they're transitioning from a medium to a large fin. And when you're a lighter person like me, 155, 160, and you want to try a large fin, you also have to be concerned about flex, right? Let's look at the John John fin, right? It's got carbon up to here, so the base is really stiff compared to a black stick Craig Anderson fin. Now, what I like about futures is they have the ride number, and the ride number is talking about flex from 1 to 10, 1 being very stiff, 10 being very flexible. The more flexible the fin, the more drive you're gonna get out of that fin, and you want that in smaller waves. Now, the Craig Anderson fin is a bit more upright compared to the John John fin, so we know it's gonna be loose, right? Now, I want this flex working for me. Now, if you get into a speed generating fin like a black stick and you're light at 155 pounds, go for a fin that's more higher up on the ride number. So this is in the high mid to nine, low to mid nines. This is a great fin for a lighter guy. And it's gonna feel loose and you're gonna get flex and spring in and out of turns, right? When would somebody about 155, 160 pounds wanna step into a stiffer fin? I'd go with the honeycomb, like the AM2s, when the waves get a little bit bigger, I use that sweep and rake to my advantage. Now, same question for us FCS2 guys. what fin could you step into and what and why and how? So the Mick Fanning has a lot of sweep or rake, right? So we're gonna tighten the board up, we're gonna stabilize it. See, but Mick Fanning's, his center fin is the same size as both the sides. So how do you loosen that up? Put a smaller center fin in. You can get maybe just a single center fin from FCS, buy a medium so it has the same template, and now you've got the side fins with a ton of drive, stability, and tighten up the board a little bit when the waves get bigger, and that center fin will loosen it up when the waves are a little bit smaller, right? And a perfect example of that is, here's the Kalohandina Large, and I'll take the medium center fin, and I've got the best of both worlds. Here's a neutral fin, it's performance core, so it's got some good flex in and out of turns, and the center fin is smaller, and it keeps the board nice and lively and loose, and I feel like I'm not gonna, the transition from a medium fin to a large fin isn't gonna be so dramatic. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed today's vlog on fins and a little bit about how this can help you and make good fin choices and keeping surfing fun and playful and learning along the way. Some of the comments that I've heard on the YouTube blog is people are going, switching from a medium fin to a large fin has changed my surfing life. Look, we got to remember, Kalohandina riding a large fin. He weighs less than I do or roughly the same. Or Philippe Toledo's riding a large fin and he's 143 pounds. So all I'm saying is be open, try some different things and have fun. That's it for now. See you in the water. Bye-bye.